Protecting user privacy is crucial for any app, especially when it handles sensitive data. Blurring privacy-sensitive information when the app moves to the background ensures that sensitive details remain hidden until the user actively engages with the app again. This approach not only enhances privacy, but also builds trust with your users. In this video, you'll learn exactly how to implement this feature in SwiftUI, step by step, to safeguard your app's data seamlessly. And if you like these types of tutorials, go ahead and check out the link in the description for my mentoring sessions. Now, today we are going to talk about privacy, how to make privacy-sensitive data inside your app. More specifically, when we are moving our app into the background. So let me show you what I mean. I have prepared a demo project right over here. It is basically just a starter project. And when I build and run, you will see that we have Hello World. Okay, so if I double tap over here, it means that it's just going to go back. You see, we still can read Hello World right over there, right? This is what I want to exclude. I want to kind of blur it or just reduce it however I can. So let's just do this. And it turns out there is actually a built-in SwiftUI modifier in iOS 18. So it is actually called privacy sensitive. So I'm just going to go with the text only so you can see the differences. You know, globe will not be, the text will be. So dot privacy sensitive. And of course, there is a Boolean value. You can toggle it on with the state variable if you choose to. Let's just go with the first one, privacy sensitive. Let's build and run again. Let's see how it looks like. And double click over here. And you might have missed it if you blinked it, but here we go. We have that redacted and it's really, really nice. Let me just go back. As you can see now, it's coming into the foreground so we can actually reveal the text. And then let me do that again. Double click. There we go. By the way, I'm just going to move all of these out of the way. Oh, not that one, but let's build and run again. And try it. There we go. There we go. You see? That's nice. Much nicer. Okay, so that's great, but it is standard. So maybe you want to blur it. Maybe you want to do add an opacity to it. Maybe you want to add a color to it, whatever. So today I'm going to build out this custom view modifier that we are going to use in this case. With years of experience working with SwiftUI, I've developed a deep understanding of its capabilities and how to apply it effectively in real-world projects. My mentoring sessions are focused on helping you build a solid foundation, refine your skills, and approach challenges with confidence. By learning from an experienced, you can accelerate your growth, avoid common mistakes, and gain a cleaner perspective on how to use SwiftUI to its fullest potential. If you're looking to strengthen your expertise and take your development to the next level, my mentorship can guide you there. The link is in the description. So first of all, we need a view modifier. I'm going to use also the privacy sensitive if you choose to use that one with this combo. So let's just build it out first. I'm going to do this on one file. I know you should just put it away into another separate folder, file and folder. You know, it's not in the content view. For now, let's just start view modifier. There we go. And let's just name our view modifier to be redacted privacy view modifier. Okay, that's fine. I'm going to remove the preview and basically everything that is a default. What we are going to need is somehow know when we are in foreground or in background. And easiest way to do that in SwiftUI is with the environment of scene face. So at environment, and it will be dot scene face, var scene face, that's okay. So now what we want to do is just add dot redacted. And you see, it's basically the same thing as the privacy sensitive. It's just going to ask a reason, and that nice animation that we had is the reason of placeholder indeed. So we can choose that, but of course we don't want the placeholder, the redacted placeholder, to be added continuously. So we are going to add it only when the scene phase is not active. So let's choose the scene phase. Let me just add scene phase. It's if it's equal to dot active. There is also an inactive and a background. That's why I'm choosing active right over here. So if it is active, I just use a ternary operator right over here, then we're going to just simply initialize that in it. Otherwise, let's just use the placeholder. So dot placeholder. Okay, that should go okay. Let's see, equals active, then we are going to have the init, otherwise the placeholder. Also, I want to have this nice animation, not just popping it out. So we're just going to have animation with the animation and value. Default will be fine. You could choose otherwise. And then the value when the scene phase changes. That's why when I want this default animation. So scene phase. So now it's time to create a view modifier, so an extension on the view. I'm going to pop it all the way up over here. We're going to come back here frequently. So extension on the view, and let's just make this function privacy sensitive. Okay, but I'm going to be able to use that one because it's already taken. I'm going to have here a style. So what is that style? Well, let's create it. It's an enum and privacy sensitive style. There we go. And let's have some cases. Case, let's just use the default one first. Where is that one? So if we type out the default, you see, we cannot actually use it. So we needed to put it into two tildes right over here. So this will be the default and then case redacted. Okay, so this is our redacted. I'm going to add in the style for now over here. So style, that will be privacy sensitive style, and in our case let's just use the default value, or yeah, let's not use the default value because again it will contradict with this privacy sensitive from SwiftUI, and let's return self over here. Now other cases that we are going to cover today, let's just hit command D, not redacted but blur, command V, opacity, and then we are also going to create a custom color one, so custom, and let's just have a color, and also add a corner radius. If you were paying attention, the redacted had a nice corner radius. We want to have that flexibility ourselves too. Corner radius, CG float. Okay, so these will be our privacy sensitive styles. Did I type that out correctly? There we go, sensitive style. Okay, so sensitive style. What we are going to do is just loop through all of them. So group, inside the group. And because, you know, it's just going to return multiple types of views, I'm just going to add the view builder right over here. We're going to switch through all of the styles. There we go, default, redacted, all of that stuff. And then we are just going to add in some code. So for now, we have the default one, which is simply privacy sensitive from SwiftUI. And then we have this redacted, and that is modifier, and that is the redacted privacy view modifier. Okay, that's fine. I'm going to add in the same modifier for these three, but yeah, we are going to change it along the tutorial. Okay, so now what we can do is just come over here. Instead of just privacy sensitive, you can just go privacy sensitive and let's just choose a style, and let's go for our redacted one. At the moment, you will not see any difference because I believe, by the way, SwiftUI's version is redacted under the hood. So let's see. There we go. We still have, well, we have a little bit of a nice animation added on. That's kind of the difference. Let me just see it again. Yes. There we go. Okay. So that is redacted. There's still blur, opacity, and custom. So let's build it out. I'm going to copy out my view modifier because many of the things still remain. What we need is the opacity. Oh, sorry. Let's start with the blur. Blur privacy view modder blur. And that's okay. What I'm going to do is immediately change it right over here. Blur. And what we need is a blur radius right over here. Instead of redacted, you see we have redacted right over here. Instead of it, we are going to use actually a blur. So, blur, and we are going to use the one with just a simple radius. And we are going to check if the scene phase is not equal dot active, it's not equal in this case, then we are going to set it to 5, otherwise 0. The same lines will, you know, the other lines still stay the same. Let's check this out. So now let's change this to blur. And let's build and run. There we go. Double click over here. No, sorry, I did not double click. There we go. Really nice. So yeah, a little bit of customization. Let's go for the opacity. Scroll down, copy, paste, and rename this to opacity. And then what we want to do is instead of a blur, we are going to have opacity. Let's just change this line, opacacity. And again, we are going to go against the active phase of the scene phase. So scene phase, if it's not dot active, then we're going to set this to 0. Otherwise, it's just going to be a 1. Okay, so now let's add opacity right over here. And then let's select opacity. There we go. So let's test this out, and then we are going to build out the most interesting one with the color. So double click over here. You see, it just simply disappeared. Really nice. Let's see that again. Double click. It just disappeared. Of course, we just removed the opacity. Really nice. Finally, let's talk about this custom one. It's just going to have a color. Let's just scroll down and copy and paste this. So it will be called color privacy view model with a capital C. And it's just going to need some extra stuff. You know, we are going to add in the color and also the corner radius. So let's add in a variable called color of type color. And also another variable of corner radius. We're not going to give a default values. These are going to be provided. Okay, so now instead of opacity or whatever, we are going to add in here an overlay. Overlay. Okay, I prefer the other type of code completion. Okay, so we're going to choose the color. That's great. And then we are going to either show the color or not, because, you know, it's an overlay. And here we are going to use the opacity. And let me just see if it did add this correctly. So scene phase, if it is actually active, if it is active, then it's going to be 1. Otherwise, it's just going to be 0. And then let's apply also the corner radius. And for that, we are going to use the clip shape. So clip shape of rounded rectangle with the corner radius of corner radius. Okay, and basically that's it. It's as simple as that. Now let's add this to our view modifier. There we go. This will be our color modifier. Where is it? I'm just going to copy it out. Let's see, color privacy view modifier. Color privacy view modifier with no scene phase is needed over here. I should have made it that private, but it's up to you. Maybe you want to set it to private. And then our corner radius. Okay, so now we can just go dot custom. And then let's just choose a color, corner radius 20. That's fine. So let's build and run. And let's see this in action. Build has succeeded. Oh, I need to change the activity. I thought so. Let's just have that as not active. Yeah, when it's not active, then add it on there. So double click. There we go. We have that nice red one coming back. Really, really nice. Now, that is how you can handle privacy inside your app when you are going into the background. If you like these types of tutorials, go ahead and check out my mentoring sessions. The link is down in the description.